Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install and configure a DNS server in Windows Server 2019. I will also test the DNS server by using another machine. This server is a domain controller for the domain adatom.com. If you already added a DNS role when you installed the ADDS service, you will have a DNS menu on the server manager. Also, you will have a DNS item under Tools menu. This server has a network card configured with a static IP address 172.16.0.10. I will go to the dashboard of Server Manager and then select Add Roles and Features. Then I will go Next, Next again, Next again. From Select Server Roles screen, I will check the DNS server item. And then I will click on Add Features and then go Next, Next again, Next again. I will also check Restart the destination server automatically if required and then click on Yes and then Install. This installation is going to take 1 or 2 minutes to finish. The installation is complete, so click on Close. As you can see, there is a new DNS menu item under the Server Manager. Also, if I go to the Tools menu, I will see an item DNS. If I click on this DNS menu item, it will open DNS Manager. I can see the LON DC1 under DNS. I will expand and then I will also expand forward lookup zones and reverse lookup zone. In many cases, you will see a forward lookup zone automatically added if you add DNS in the domain controller. If not automatically added, then go to the forward lookup zone and then create a new zone. I will right click on the empty space and select new zone. Then I will go next and primary zone, go next, keep the default and go next. And then for the zone name, I will type in the domain name adatom.com and then go next, next again, and then finish. The adatom.com domain has been added. Also, inside that domain, I can see there are SOA records, NS record, and a host record for this machine. In the reverse lookup zone, I will create a new zone. So I right click on the reverse lookup zone and then select new zone. Go next, next again, next again, next again. And then in the network ID part, I'll type in the part of the network address for this machine. So 172.16.0. And then go next, next again, and finish. Now I expand the reverse lookup zone, and I can see there is an SOA record and NS record. Since a pointer record was not added for the host LON DC1, I can add that pointer record in the reverse lookup zone. To get a pointer record in the reverse lookup zone, I will right click on LON DC1 and then go to Properties. And then I will uncheck and check again the update associated pointer records that will create a pointer record in the reverse lookup zone. It did reflect a pointer record in the reverse lookup zone. Next, I'm going to add different other types of records such as MX record, CNAME record, and host record for all the servers. I will power on a server and check its IP address and computer name to add a host record. The second server is powered on and I'm in the server manager. So I'll go to the local server. The IP address is 172.16.0.12. The computer name is lon server 21234. So I will add a host record for this name and this IP. So I go back to the DNS server, and then in the domain, I will right click and then select new host. For the name, it was lon srv2-1234 and IP was 172.16.0.12. Also, I'll make sure create associated pointer record is checked so that a related pointer record is created in the reverse lookup zone. So click on add host. In this way, you need to add all the servers' IP addresses and their names as host records. So I'll close this one, go to the reverse lookup zone, and I don't see the pointer record yet, so I will refresh and the pointer record is now visible. All right, other types of records you will need in your domain would be CNAME record. When we access a website, we type in an address like www and then the domain name. The www is a canonical name or alias name or CNAME. So I'll add that record, right click and then new alias. I will type www and then for the target, I will browse and point to the web server name. Let's say that lon dc1 is the web server. So we'll point to lon dc1 and press on OK. When a user types in www.adatom.com, that request will actually go to lon dc1.adatom.com computer. So by using this kind of alias name, people on the internet doesn't need to know actual computer name of different organization. They can use the common name www. So I press on OK. Similarly, I will add an FTP alias name and point to the FTP server. Again, let's say lon dc1 is the FTP server. Other types of record you will need in a DNS server would be a mail exchange record. So I'll right click and then select new mail exchange record or MX record. And I will use mail so that the mail server will be known as mail.adatom.com, and I will browse and point to the mail server. Let's say lon dc1 is the mail server. So I press OK. Next, I'm going to test if this DNS server is giving the name resolution to the clients. So I'll go to the other server and configure its network card to use the lon dc1 as the DNS server. So go to network configuration. IPv4 setting, and in the DNS server address, I will use lon dc1's IP address, which is 172.16.0.10. So press OK and OK again. To enforce the changes, I will disable the network card and then enable again. Also on lon dc1, I will restart the DNS server. So right click on the lon dc1 computer name and then all tasks and restart. The DNS server has been restarted. Now I'm gonna go to lon srv2 and test DNS functionalities by pinging the computers with names. close this window and then open command prompt cmd. First, I will ping lon dc1 by its name. I'm getting a ping reply. That means this computer can be reached by name. Next, I'm gonna ping www.adatom.com and I'm also getting a ping reply. So the DNS server in lon dc1 is working. And that is the end of this video. I hope you found this video was helpful. If you'd like to receive notifications on future videos, please make sure you're subscribed to my channel and set up notifications by tapping on the bell. Thank you for watching.